Mixed martial artist Carlos Condit, aka the Natural Born Killer, started his career a decade ago as a cage fighter. Now, his decisive skill and strategy instill fear among his opponents, who call him tough and difficult.
Yes, Carlos is ranked as one of the top 10 pound-for-pound fighters in the world, and earlier this month won the Ultimate Fighting Championship Interim Welterweight title, defeating Nick Diaz.
Woo-hoo.
So what's next for New Mexico's favorite son?
Hi, Carlos.
Hi, how are you guys?
Welcome. It's so nice to have you here.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, definitely.
Such a pleasure.
Thank you for being
really
here.
Really an honor for us. Thank you. And yeah, so what's on the agenda for you right now?
Up next is probably a fight with George St. Pierre, who is the undisputed welterweight champion.
Mm-hmm.
He is out with a knee injury, so we're slated to fight probably later this year. So
okay.
I'll just be training and preparing for that fight.
I can't even imagine what that training must be like.
pretty tough. Well, you were one of the UFC's most exciting competitors with 13 knockouts and 13 submissions. How hard is it for you to stick with the game plan and not just pound on Nick Diaz during a fight like that?
I always step into the cage with a game plan, and it's usually to, you know, put the other guy's lights out. But
yeah.
Nick Diaz is a really, really tough opponent, and you know, hard to finish. And I just had to stay focused, and I had trained for that fight for 6 months.
Oh, I can imagine.
And so it was almost just muscle memory at that point.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So you kind of have that guideline. You have that set plan of what your plan of action actually is for attack, but then you're in that moment and you really do have to go with your gut, literally.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's a lot of experience that goes into it,
mm-hmm.
too. And I, like you said, I've been at this game for almost a decade.
Yeah.
And,
wow.
had over 30 professional fights, so I've been around the block.
You got a little experience under your belt. Now, we have a Best of Carlos Condit clip I want to take a look at as well, because that way we can show everybody you in action. So tell me what we're looking at here.
It's like a walk out to the cage. Nice little highlight reel.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nice body of work, man.
That's amazing. I would imagine in addition to all the physical strength, it must take so much mental strength as well for every fight.
Yeah, without a doubt. I think mental preparation is, probably 90% of it.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of guys can look great in the gym and be the best athlete, but it's really a psychological war.
Mm-hmm. How much did the crowd play into it during those fights?
Quite a bit. I feed off the crowd. It gives me motivation. I love fans' reaction when you do something exciting or you do something that they like.
Mm-hmm.
But for the most part, you're just focused on the guy who's across the cage who's trying to kick your butt.
Well, every fight is different. You wouldn't train for a Nick Diaz the same way you would for a George St. Pierre. What's the most difficult part about training for a fight?
I would say it's the day in, day out grind.
Okay.
I love what I do.
Sure.
But training three times a day, four times a day.
Wow.
Oh my gosh.
Five to six days a week with while cutting weight and everything that goes into it.
Yeah.
It's it can be tedious and taxing, mm-hmm. at times, but I really feel fortunate to be doing what I love for a living.
Oh, I bet. Well, I mean, not only the workout plan has to be very strict, but I would imagine so does the diet.
Yeah, I walk around maybe 190, and I fight at 170.
Is that your natural weight?
Yeah. So I fight about 170. So
wow.
It's kind of a tough cut.
It is.
That's a lot of weight.
Speaking of tough, who's been your toughest opponent so far?
I would say my last title defense in the WEC, which was a different organization,
uh-huh.
that I held a belt in.
Yeah.
I fought a guy named Hiromitsu Mira. He's a Japanese guy who had come down from 185 and was just super tough. He had been like an Olympic level judo player, and it was a very, very tough opponent.
I bet.
Now, if you could have a rematch, who would it be?
I would like to fight Martin Campman, who's actually fighting this weekend in the UFC in Australia. He was my first loss in UFC, my UFC debut, and we have had a very, very close fight, lost a split decision, and I'd like to get that win back.
Yeah.
That loss.
Okay, the challenge is on. Well, okay, let me ask you this. We talk about rematches, but what was the proudest moment that you've had so far?
Proudest moment? I would say, you know, when I beat Nick Diaz a few weeks ago and got this belt.
I have to say, Carlos, it has to be a proud moment for everybody in New Mexico. I mean, I was on Facebook that night during the fight and watching what was going on, and just in social media every second it was about you. Everything was about you, and just how many people are behind you and support you. And it's got to feel so good to have, you know, everybody behind you like that, and just knowing that so many people want the win for you.
Without a doubt, you know, I have so much support from my hometown and my state.
Yeah,
and
of course.
I'm, you know, just so proud to represent New Mexico on the world stage and, you know, in an organization like UFC. It's, you know, it's cool personally to you know, achieve my goals, but sure. Also, you know, like I said, representing my community is a big motivation for me.
Oh, and I know your community's proud, too, for sure.
Well, let's go back to the beginning.
Yeah.
As a youngster, you approached your dad about grappling, and you were soon on your way to being a cage fighter. What did you find so appealing about mixed martial arts?
Well, I started wrestling when I was about 9 years old and was always just drawn to contact sports and combat sports.
Yeah.
You know, I just had a passion for it. You know, I just like to fight even as a young kid. So, you know, this gave me an outlet where I could do that in a positive way.
Definitely, and to be an inspiration to people and set a great example as well. And I mean, obviously, this is your passion. But if there was any other thing you could do professionally, would there be another choice as well?
I would probably do like a high intensity, high adrenaline job, maybe like a firefighter, or you know, maybe, you know, possibly a job in the military, something like that.
Special forces.
Interesting. That's good to know. But you're not just a fighter; you're a lover and a fighter, because you also, family's a big part of your life. I know your wife and son are a huge part of your life. Can you tell us a little bit about them?
I have a 2-year-old son named Owen, who is just, you know, everything to me, and you know, huge motivation. Mm-hmm. And my wife Seeger, you know, she's a personal trainer, and just, you know, we it's awesome. She's amazing.
Well, you guys are a beautiful family as well.
And also, you're a businessman.
Yeah.
Tell us about your Dress to Kill Clothier, located right here in Albuquerque.
I love that name, by the way, Dress to Kill. That's awesome.
Yeah, it's pretty cool, huh? We have a men's clothier. It's you know, it's a small store, but we have really, really nice stuff, high end. We cater to you know, kind of a younger market.
Uh-huh.
You know, guys who maybe aren't necessarily, you know, comfortable in suits or don't know a whole lot about dressing up. And, you know, we have some great stuff located right by the Hotel Andalus.
So
it's an awesome location.
That's great. So yeah, definitely we want to tell people to get on out, and if they want to look like Carlos Condit.
Well, before we go, what advice would you give a young kid who may be thinking about mixed martial arts?
I would say, really try to learn several disciplines.
Okay.
You know, a lot of people start off with one and then try to, you know, incorporate, you know, say a little bit of wrestling to supplement their kickboxing game.
Mm-hmm.
But I would say try to learn everything and become as well-rounded as possible.
Mm, good advice.
Carlos, do you think I could get you to sign this?
Aww.
I can do that.
Carlos, thanks. You so much. We really appreciate you being here and sharing your story with us and sharing all that you do for the community and, of course, for the fighting world.
Yes, thank you. And
well,
for representing New Mexico.
Yeah. Thank you very much for having me.
Thank you so
thanks,
much.
Champ.
And still ahead on New Mexico Style, how that old bridesmaid dress can make a young girl's dream come true.